Hello all my dear chemist and scientist, I am Kamal Pradhan and I am going to discuss about the Warner's theory of coordination compounds and the isomerism of coordination compounds. First, Warner's theory of coordination compounds. The various steps of Warner's explanation regarding to complex compounds will be discussed in this video. The important postulates of Warner's theory are metal possess two types of valencies. First is the primary or ionizable valency and second is the secondary or non-ionizable valency. Now, what is primary valency? These are the valencies which the metal atoms show in the formation of its simple salt. For example, in the formation of CuSO4, copper sulfate, COCl3, PtCl4, the primary valency of copper is E2, that of cobalt is 3 and that of platinum is 4. Now, the secondary valency. These are the valencies which the metal atom or cation show towards the ligand, that is the neutral molecules or ions, in the formation of its complex ions. The secondary valency of a metal atom or ion is equal to the number of coordination bond which the ligands form with it. It is also called the coordination number of the cation or the center metal atom. For example, in the complex CuNH3O4+, the secondary valency of copper is 4 because it is connected with 4 amine ligand. Similarly, in the complex CuNH3O3Cl3, the secondary valency of cobalt is 6 because the coordination number of cobalt in this complex is 6, as there are 3 ammonia molecule and 3 chlorine ion are coordinated with the central metal atom cobalt. Now, second step, which is explained by the Warner, is every metal atom has a tendency to satisfy both its primary and secondary valency. Primary valency are satisfied by the negative ion, whereas the secondary valency are satisfied by the ligands, that is the neutral molecules and the negative ions. Next, third step of Warner's explanation is the primary valency is non-directional while the secondary valency is directional. Next, the fourth point is the ligands satisfying secondary valencies are always directed towards fixed position in space and give the definite geometry to the complex compound. 4 such ligands may give square planar or tetrahedral structure to the complex ion, whereas 6 such ligands give octahedral geometry to the complex or coordination compounds. 2 ligands arranged themselves in linear geometry. Next, the fifth point is every metal atom has a fixed number of secondary valencies or coordination number. And the sixth point is primary valency are designated by the dotted line, whereas the secondary valency are designated by the solid lines. As you know, the primary valency is ionizable, whereas the secondary valency is non-ionizable. In order to explain the experimental facts about the nature of complex compounds COCl3 6NH3, Warner assigned the structural formula of the compound. In this structure, 6 ammonia molecules are bonded to central metal atom cobalt by secondary valency, that is the solid line, and 3 chlorine atoms are bonded to central metal atom cobalt by primary valency, that is through the dotted lines. The structure of COCl3 5NH3 H2O, COCl3 5NH3, COCl3 4NH3 and COCl3 3NH3 can be represented similarly. Structure thought to be indicate that some of the negative ligands such as chlorine are performing dual behavior, that is, which are satisfying both primary and secondary valencies. So the valencies are shown by double lines, that is, both by solid line and also by dotted lines. This type of ions or atoms which show both primary and secondary valency are non-ionizable in nature. In modern terms, we can say the complex ion containing non-ionizable ligands are present inside the square bracket or inside the coordination sphere, whereas the ionizable ligands are present outside the square bracket or outside the coordination sphere. The primary valencies are called ionic bonds, while the secondary valency are called coordinate bonds. These are the postulates of Wagner's theory of coordination compounds. Next, what are the drawbacks of Wagner's theory of coordination compounds? First is, Wagner does not able to explain the cause of various properties like color of coordination complex, geometry and the magnetic properties of coordination complex. And the second point of drawbacks of Wagner theory is Wagner had no justification or no any type of proof for his proposed theory. Next, the important observations from Wagner's theory. The complex compounds do not show the properties of the central metal atom or ion and those of the ligands which are coordinated with the central metal atom or ion in the complex compounds. For example, when the complex CrNH3O3Cl3 which are within the square bracket is put in water, the solution does not give white precipitate with AgNO3 solution. You can say the chloride ion lose their ionic character within the coordination compounds. The next point is the constituents atom or groups which present outside the coordination sphere or outside the square bracket can able to give test. For example, in the complex K2PtCl6 and CrNH3O6SO4, in both the complex, the potassium first complex, potassium is present outside the square bracket, and in the second complex, sulfate is present outside the square bracket. So first complex give K plus test, whereas the second complex is SO4 2 minus test. These two points are the observation of Wagner's theory of coordination compound. Now we will discuss about the isomerism of coordination compounds. What is isomerism? When the same molecular formula represents two or more compounds but they differ in their physical and chemical properties, then such compounds are called the isomers, and the phenomenon is called isomerism. Isomerism is of two types. One is structural isomerism and second is the stereoisomerism. Next, again, the structural isomerism are of four types. First is the ionization isomerism, second is the hydrate isomerism, third is the linkage isomerism, and the fourth is the coordination isomerism. And the stereoisomerism is of two types. One is geometrical isomerism, that is also called the cis trans isomerism, and the second is optical isomerism. Now we will study or we will discuss about the ionization isomerism, that is a type of structural isomerism. Ionization isomerism is the type of isomerism in which the composition of the compound is same, but the compounds liberate different ions in solution. For example, in the complex CONH3O5SO4Br, it liberates Br- ion because Br is present outside the coordination sphere, and the solution color is red, and it gives pale yellow precipitate when react with AgNO3 solution, and it produce AgBr or silver bromide. Next, the same type composition compound is CONH3O5Br and SO4, and SO4 is present outside the square bracket, so it gives or it liberates SO4 2 minus ion, and the solution is purple in color. It gives white precipitate while treated with BaCl2 solution. Next is the hydrate isomerism. This type of isomerism is shown by the compounds which have the same composition but differ in the number of molecules of water inside the coordination sphere. The water molecules present outside the coordination sphere react with concentrated sulfuric acid solution. For example, CrH2O6Cl3, this compound is violet in color and it does not lose any water molecule while treated with concentrated sulfuric acid solution. This same composition compound is CrH2O5Cl and Cl2H2O. In this complex, the color is blue and it loses one water molecule while treated with concentrated sulfuric acid solution. The compound CrH2O4Cl2H2O, this compound is green in color and it loses two water molecules when treated with concentrated sulfuric acid solution. So these three compounds have the same composition, but they have the different physical and chemical properties. Next is the linkage isomerism. It is also a type of structural isomerism. This type of isomerism is shown by the compounds containing ambidentate ligand. Ambidentate ligand means it is a monodentate ligand, but it contains two donor atoms. For example, in the complex CONH3O5ONOCl2, here oxygen atom is bonded, or oxygen atom is coordinated with the central metal atom cobalt, and the color of the compound is red, and it does not decompose by acids. But the same composed complex, which is CONH3O5NO2Cl2, here the nitrogen atom of nitro group is coordinated with the cobalt, and the color of the complex is yellow, and it does not decompose by any type of acids. Next is the coordination isomerism. This type of isomerism occurs in compounds containing both cationic and anionic complexes having the same or different central metal atom or ion. For example, the complex CONH3O4PtCl4 and PtNH3O4CuCl4. Here the central metal atom is different. It also show coordination isomerism. Another type of complex like CrNH3O6CrCn6 and CrNH3O4CN2 and CrNH3O2CN4. These compounds contain the same central metal atom, and these compounds also show coordination isomerism. Next is the stereoisomerism. When the same molecular formula represents two or more compounds which differ in their spatial arrangement of atoms or groups around the central metal atom or ion, then such compounds are called stereoisomers, and the phenomenon is called stereoisomerism. There are two types of stereoisomerism. One is geometrical isomerism, it is also called cis trans isomerism, and then second type of stereoisomerism is optical isomerism. First is the geometrical isomerism or cis trans isomerism. This type of isomerism is due to the ligands occupying different position around the central metal atom or ion. If the same type of ligand occupy adjacent position to each other in the complex compound, then it is called cis isomer. And if the ligands contain opposite position to each other, then it is called the trans isomer. Geometrical isomerism is shown by compounds having coordination number 4, that is square planar complex, and having coordination number 6, that is the octahedral complex. Tetrahedral complexes does not show geometrical isomerism because all ligands in tetrahedral complexes are equidistant from each other. Square planar complexes of the type MA2X2, MA2X2, MABX2, MABXY can exist as cis trans isomers or geometrical isomers, where A and B are neutral ligands and X and Y are anionic ligands. Type Ma2H2 includes the example of PtNH3Hol2Cl2, PtPyHol2Cl2. Type Ma2XY include CONH3Hol2ClBr, PtPyHol2NH3Cl. Type MABXY includes the example of PtNH3, Py, NH2OH, NO2. Next is the octahedral complex of the type MA4X2 or MA4XY can exist as cis trans isomer. Type MA4X2 or MA4XY include the example of CONH3Hol4Cl2 and CONH3Hol4ClNO2. Next is the optical isomerism. It is also a type of stereoisomerism. An optically active substance is that which exhibits such two structures which are non-superimposable and are not related as object and its mirror image. Coordination number 4, that is the square planar complexes, do not show the optical isomerism, but tetrahedral complex show optical isomerism, but the tetrahedral complex has the unsymmetrical bidentate ligand. Square planar complex do not show optical isomerism because they have the plane of symmetry. So the mirror image and the object image is same. So square planar complex does not show optical isomerism and tetrahedral complex always show optical isomerism having the unsymmetrical bidentate ligands. The complexes having the coordination number 6 like MAAH2Y2, MAAHol2X2, MAAHol3 show the optical isomerism. Here AA means it is a chelating ligand. Type MAAX2Y2 include the example of CoEn NH3Hol2Cl2 plus. Type MAAHol2X2 include the example of CoEnHol2Cl2 plus. Type MAAHol3 include the example of CoEnHol3 3+. That's all. Please like, share and subscribe my channel and press the bell icon, otherwise you will get the notification of my next video.